am I called to coaching, or have I chosen coaching because it looks good, right? Those are two different things. And so as a coach, you want a coach so they can hold you accountable to the call. Number two, hiring or working with a coach, when you're a coach, it stretches you. Let me tell y'all, it stretches you. When I worked with my first coach, it's so ironic how the program that I enrolled in wasn't anything of what I gained out of the program, if that makes any sense. Like, I paid for the program, I enrolled in the program. It was a great program, but it wasn't what her marketing or her content told me that I would receive. That's not what I received. I received something totally different. Right? It stretched me. It forced me to think differently. It forced me to move some stuff around. It forced me to move some stuff up and move some stuff down. It really challenged me, and it made me stretch myself in coaching. Another program that I enrolled in, same thing. I enrolled. This one was at a higher price point. I'm like, yes, I'm about to rock out. I get into the program, and it's completely different. I learned something completely different than what I had expected. When you hire or when you work with a coach, when you're a coach, it stretches you. Sometimes we feel like because we're experts in an industry or we're experts in a particular area that, you know, we have the answers. And don't get me wrong, you are an expert in the problem that you solve, but we can't omit the problems that we still have that we may not be focusing on or that we can see in our own coaching businesses. Right? So coaches need coaches because it really stretches you in your ability. You may feel amazing in what you do now, right? But just imagine working with a coach who's able to see your blind spots, who's able to help you stretch, who's able to pull you further. It's just like an athletic coach, right? We have athletes who are born with an amazing ability to catch a ball, throw a ball, whatever sport they're in. But what makes the coach so unique is because I can really help you sharpen that skill. I can really help you help that skill really manifest through you and show and become more than what you probably could have done on your own. Hiring or working with a coach allows you to do that, right? It stretches you. It forces you to reposition yourself, rethink what you're doing as a coach, reposition your coaching strategies, reposition your framework. It forces you to dig deeper. Now, here's the thing. All coaching programs are not created equal, right? I asked a question, have you ever invested in a coaching program where you had no physical contact with the actual coach? And I hear people say this all the time. I enrolled into a training. I paid a couple thousand for this training, and all they gave me was a bunch of downloads. They just gave me a bunch of videos to watch. Well, is that conducive to your growth? How do you learn? What do you need as a coach? These are very important things that you have to think about, because as you're building your coaching business, you need the accountability. And if a video is good enough to hold you accountable, then listen, by all means, rock out. But if you know that there's more that you need as a coach in your coaching business, understand that hiring a coach is not only for financial gain. Let's get that clear, right? Hiring a coach is not only for financial gain. Don't get me wrong. You do want a return on your investment, but you have to identify what the return is. Because as I just stated to you guys, I've enrolled in two coaching programs where the return on my investment was way greater than the financial or the immediate return that I had assumed in that moment. Right? So you want to really identify as a coach, not only what type of coach you are. Remember, we've been talking about your titling. We've been talking about your ideal client. We've been talking about all of these things about your coaching business. But not only do you want to really sit down and identify and gain clarity on the type of coach you are, but you want to identify what type of coach you need, because a coach is going to help you become the coach that you desire to become. A coach is going to help you become the coach that God needs you to become, especially if you've been called to it, right? I believe that pastors need training. I believe anybody in ministry needs training. Teachers need trainings. Doctors need training. Whoever's in some sort of profession that's going to help solve the problem of someone else, you need training, right? And so having a coach on your team or a part of your daily, a part of your routine is going to help you stretch your business. It's going to help pull you in areas that you may have never even imagined. It's going to force you to see areas in your business that you may not have ever been able to see without this coach. Right? So just think about that. So again, we're talking about three reasons why a coach needs a coach, right? Coaches need coaches. It's super important. My last and final point is three. My third point is kind of what I just talked about the return on investment. When you have a coach, there's a different type of growth or acceleration that happens in your business. There's a different type of growth that happens in your mindset. There's a different type of growth that happens in your revenue when you hire a coach. Not only because of the information that this coach is giving you, hopefully you prayed about it and you've selected a coach that is going to help you in the season that you're in. Not just about the information or the strategies that they have for you, but more so helping you because as you sow, you reap, right? So this is the whole money system that we all are super aware of, but for whatever reason, we don't always include it into our coaching business. When you serve or invest in your coaching business with another coach, what it's doing is it's opening up space for someone to come invest into you, right? So it's a cycle that happens. You hire a coach, you invest in this coach, you plant your seeds, and then you wait for the harvest. Now, the harvest can show up in many different ways. It can show up in the information that you gain, the experience that you gain, the partnerships, the collaborations, the income that you make. It's so many different things that you can get out of this cycle or this system. But if you're not willing to sow, how are you expecting to reap? Right. So I want to share with you really quickly why it was hard for me to hire a coach. I had been taught that sowing and reaping concept forever. Right. But I didn't believe it. I didn't believe it happened. I'm like, whatever. People will come. I don't need to hire a coach. I am a coach. And I thought that Google was good enough. I did. I thought that, you know, Google was good enough. I had did some training. Cool. I'm good. And it wasn't. It wasn't even that Google wasn't good enough. It was more so that I needed someone that understood where I was, who I was, and where I'm trying to go in my coaching business. And by doing this, it required for me to become vulnerable in my coaching business to finally say, hey, I need the help and I need the support. Now, I've always had, you know, different people on my team to help me with the company, help me build the company. But when I finally made the decision to invest into another coach to coach me, it changed something for me, right? And so my fear was embarrassment. I'm supposed to know. I'm supposed to, you know, I'm not supposed to be hiring a coach. You are the coach, but these are all the trick of the enemy. This is deception. If I can keep you stuck in your coaching business without exploring different options, without opening your mindset, without thinking, without expanding your thinking, without figuring out new ways to do new things, if you don't explore these options, you become stuck. And so remember, we talked about the difference between being called to coach and choosing to coach. So if you've been called to coach and you don't invest and you don't hire a coach, you're stunting your capability or your reach. Well, that's what the enemy wants you to do. Why? Because there's power in your coaching. Your coaching changes lives. And if I can get you to have these thoughts of embarrassment, of defeat, of thinking that you got it, thinking that Google or free downloads or free trainings is enough, then I can keep you stuck. But if you decide to think past those things and say, you know what? I know without a shadow of a doubt that I need these things, that I need this for my business, that it not just needing this for my business, I need this for me, then it changes things, right? It changes things. So that was me. I wanted to share with you guys three reasons why you needed a coach and what took me so long to finally hire a coach. I was coaching coaches. I wasn't even really coaching coaches yet when I signed up for my first coaching program. I was still coaching everybody, anybody, entrepreneurs mostly, but I hadn't really narrowed my niche yet. I was just coaching entrepreneurs. And again, hiring a coach helped me realize what my specialty was, what my expertise was, what problem I solved in my industry. And when I did that, then doors and opportunities and windows and all type of stuff began to open. So listen, I just wanted to share three reasons why coaches need to work with a coach. If you are a coach and you have the desire to rock out and build this lucrative coaching business, listen, you can do it. I know you can. You have the solution to someone's problem. Someone is waiting on you. Someone needs you. Understand there's a difference between being called to coach and choosing to coach. And if you know that you've been called to this, and how do you know? Because it's been in your blood since you were a baby. Real quick, I had a potential client on the phone, and she said, well, how do you know that this program is for me? How do you know that I should sign up for this program? And I said, you said one thing to me when you got on the phone. You said, I've been coaching my whole life. I just didn't know how to monetize it. That's when I know. Right? When you know that you've been doing something, I've been coaching. Ask my friends, ask my family. This is who I've been my entire life. And when you're able to say that, then that's when you know that coaching has been a call. Now the question is, are you going to monetize your ability to help see people through their current situations, their current circumstances, to gain better results in their life? Right? And are you going to connect with a coach who can help you do that? Cool. Listen, make sure you get connected and join my email list for your free book. And make sure you make sure you get connected and schedule a free call with me so that you can learn more about my coaching program. And then make sure you stay connected and join my email list for your free book. Listen, I love you guys. Thank you so much for rocking out with me for my afternoon strategy session. Have a fantastic day, and we'll meet again tomorrow. Be blessed.